Something starts to smell around here.
Power supply on, so we can see what's going on. Any promises now can we be? There you go. You saw what happened. Shit. And there's a switch here that acts like a trigger. So here we go.
Spray, have a spray, don't pass. Yeah. All you need to do is to spray over the walkway like this. Dark jeans and your Nikes, look at you. Oh, damn.
Holy. Heard you at all if the voltage is set very low up there. See, with their end connected to a cable where I can just plug into the wall. Okay, there we are.
The whole city is melted. Oh!
Replacing the light bulb is one of the simple things to do.
So don't overheat your magnets. Goodbye, love. Ouch. Not everything hot is kissable. Voltage level, you can adjust its scale using a knob, and the horizontal axis is for time that you can adjust its scale using the other knob. This can tell you tons about what you're measuring. For example, if I measure the outlet voltage,
I think the gap between the wires is a little bit too wide for the 2 kilovolt to jump across. Ow! My puny wires melted. What if I put a capacitor between the rods so that when the arcs reach them, the capacitor blows up for some firework effects? Gosh. And what if I add some sparklers to it? It's getting there. Oh my god! Oh! Yay! Let's make it fancier. Things happen to good people. Let's see if I can weld these pieces. Don't touch hot stuff. Let's play Pink Panther. My f***ing brain cells! Now let's reduce the voltage level and increase the frequency all the way to 60.
I shut my ass sitting on these live wires. Always clean up the lab, otherwise something will bite you in. Inductor blocks AC. Okay, everything is hooked up and ready to go. Wow!
Oh, shit. What did I do? Okay, let's see how far the fire goes.
Magic. I wonder if it can shock me.
Lots of wine, lots of power. Let's see. It's not too bad. Okay, let's get back to the circuit. But right now, I'm touching the wire and I can't really feel it because the voltage is not high. It's to sense the temperature of the iron, feeling the hot air rising from the iron by the skin above my lips. The skin here is quite sensitive to temperature and can tell the temperature quite accurately.
Ground for negative.
Let's measure the current too. It's not making a good contact. Yes.
This gap is quite wide. Let me measure it for you. Well, you know, metal is generally conducting
10 amps through a regular pencil graphite. Wow, this is good. Oh my god! Whoa! Oh.
Okay, it's definitely shorter. Let's plug it in. Hopefully nothing will happen and I'll know. Jeez. Wow. I better clean it up before they see it.
Well, I basically ran away. The breaker for all the room outlets just popped.
It should turn or vibrate.
Too much voltage. Let me reduce it by my auto transformer. Tap into our oven somehow if I pull it back a little bit. Thanks to the stupid design of the outlet, I can pull it back a little bit and expose the high voltage band. Let's see what voltage is.
Ow! Who was that?
Stepped on stupid spaghetti down here. I have to clean it up.
Okay, let's do it. Show us if the phases are 120 degrees out or 180 degrees out. Just check.
This is super sketchy, but let's see if it works.
Okay, and we'll bond over playing these games.
So here is the jack-in-the-box contraption. You just turn it on, and anyone touches the handle will be shocked.
In some of the outlets, especially in the kitchen, they bring two phases to the outlet. And to do so, if you look here carefully, they have to cut that tiny bridge.
Always wear safety gloves to protect your fingers and don't try this at home. Let me see if I can make some arcs. Always wear safety goggles when dealing with very bright arcs. Let's try it again. Nice, look at that. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this yet? Cause I know that it's delicate. Nice. Am I on fire?
Okay, ready? Cut the hands of the MOSFET by touching the positive and negative lines through my body. And now the relay can turn on a light too. They stick an RR battery. Let's see how badly it shocks. It's getting shocked. Ouch! This is pretty painful too. Try it one more time. Ouch! Ow, I hate it! Try it one more time. Really experienced one. What the? Ow! Burn freezes. There you go, 100 amps. And it's holding on. British, oh shit. My auto transformer can't take that much power.
And feed some material through. You see the LEDs start to get red as the head heats. Let me demonstrate. I plug it in and now the rails are live, so under no circumstances you should touch the rails. Now I put the projector on.
Remember that the white wire is neutral and that's where you would be connecting your program. The white wire was neutral. I connected it backwards. I'm measuring the capacitor voltage and it's around. It's not gonna heat up because it's plastic. Now if I turn it on, it draws power from the supply to heat up the position. There is metal in something, don't put it in the microwave. More turns to get high enough voltage. And here is my handicraft. Let's measure and see where we are. It's higher. As you know, a speaker is a magnet and a coil that when you excite a coil with an AC voltage, it vibrates at the same frequency.
The first thing you need to do is to unscrew the head and rotate it and mount it on the tail by piercing into the tail. Well, never pierce a hole towards your body. This tail is a little bit tough, so I'm going to drill a hole into it. It's much more dangerous if the current runs through your body first, then into the water.
Let's try it.
Well, that was super painful, not even compatible to if you just put the spoon in the water.
Ouch! Then there's a node around here, then it's vibrating here. Let me increase the amplitude so the vibrations are more visible.
Oh, and we will hammer the head into the wood like this.
Here you go, son.
Thanks, Dad.
Holy shit.
I made this simple circuit and I'll plug it in. Now the circuit is hot and the voltage is on the circuit. I put the meter on AC and I measure the voltage.
Oh my god! Let's cut the stupid LED out to reduce the current draw a bit.
Yeah, I guess the LED wasn't drawing much. So that's it. 100 milliamp is the maximum. Watch the current carefully as I connect the capacitor. The arcs still jump to it. The hell?
Ouch!
Although the arcs are ouch! The arcs are not jumping to the screwdriver, but it burns my hand.
Connect this together. Oh, it did jump. Hey! Then glowing hot here. But in a lot of cases, eddy current can be pretty bad. Ow!
What kind of sorcery is this? Did it decide not to hurt?
No. See some AC voltage, but because the charger output and live wire are isolated, if I short them, there is no current running between them and the AC. I tied some wire to the element terminal so I can probe them. Now if I turn on the voltage, ground wire, nothing happens. And if I touch the live, never try this at home. It is okay because I'm isolated. Nothing happened. What's going on there?
Ow! Shit!
People suffering in coal mines. Loose wires. Avoid them. Oh, hey. Hey, man. Take a listen to my latest mixtape on this. Let's hear it out. Backwards. Backwards again. Hurry up, caveman. There we go. was a prank, man. You're such an idiot. You plug anything into your computer, now it's gone. You should see the look on your face right now.
But I trusted you.
It was just a prank, bro. Don't beat yourself up for your stupidity.
My life's work was on this computer.
Don't worry. It kills your USB port and likely your motherboard. What won't erase your data?
Ah, then we are good. High five.
Yeah, unless you have solid state drive memory, that is. I bought this novelty gun from my local dollar store, and when you press the trigger,
why?
Now it's ready to go. You just plug it into the power line, charges right away, and you can unplug. Then you charge.
Flash capacitor is still charged. Let's discharge it first before touching it. Things of wild and.
See, it doesn't arc anymore because I think the capacitor is loading the output voltage and reducing it. So I have to bring the contacts further close.
Ow! Shit!
Okay. All the booger water is collecting.
Oh! There's no drain! Ah!
The doors are closed.
Ouch!
Body a little bit. And then discharge.
Ow!
That was painful.
Jump start again. I had charged the super cap to 14 volts, but. Oh, crap! What the f?
520 volt AC input, and I have my capacitor and diode here, and I'm probing across the diode. Now, if I connect the circuits together. But much more current, and at the input, much well, you get the point.
Like everything is in order. The circuit is not warm. Everything is good.
Ouch. Damn it! I saved myself.
There we go. Professional plumbing done professionally. Now the question is, does it work? Of course it does. Was there ever any doubt? And here I have the CD power line. Both of them are exactly at 120 volt AC. Like behind a red light or in a charging lane. Means I remove this drain to measure the water usage. Ah, why do they use this stupid dent here that only collects dirty water and booger? Something like this inductor and capacitor. This is a filter. If I try to measure the AC output using my... The power line straight capacitors don't blow up like that.
Oh, the reason my light is turning on is because I'm hiding my Tesla coil under the table. Ow!
What they say about AC, it hurts.
Yeah.
So I'm stuck with 60 hertz for now. Let me see if I can charge my body. Put my legs up. Oh, I can feel my hair rising.
Ow! Something zapped me right in the ass.
Oh, the city voltage is a sine wave. Now if we scope it. It was the live wire. Black is grass.
And jump start the car and hopefully it will start and then I can disconnect everything. Ready, set, go!
Nothing happened.
Some plugs like this one that we can measure. Here we have...
What's up with my circuits and all the small? In conclusion, here's how Muso works in all the modes. Let me read you a passage. Once everyone else was settled in there, oh my God, he had a war, and in his
farm he had a cow. Of course, a brushless AC motor like this one that I took from an old microwave oven can last much longer than a brushless. Here, I killed it. Don't show. Anyways, with this, I'm converting the AC into DC using it. It's a single diode, but it will do. And if I measure the voltage at the output.
Holy f. The capacitor. Ah, f.
Any tone from it like this.
There is 48 volt DC on them, which is a pretty harmless voltage. Fires.
As we expect, we just have to tie the neutral wires to the ground of this.
I have a foot switch that applies the 120 volt to my valve like this.
What the f?
Exactly, almost like a hot glue gun. The heating element melts the matter.
Who plugged it in?
Super dangerous. Don't try it at home. Let me demonstrate. If I plug it into the to see how it looks like. There. Straightforward. You can see that the AC line enters from that corner and feeds it. Always make sure your circuit is disconnected from power supply before you start tinkering with it.
Of the microwave, I just put a wire in here to kickstart the arc.
Holy sh!
Well, that was dangerous.
Add more as needed to your taste.
Lots of poisonous gases. I think it's ready to serve.
Into the power line. Oh, look at this. There is blood coming out of every hair hole. Why would anyone use this piece of shit? And some electricity passes through the hair and it falls out. I assume they use something like a taser that zaps the hair dead. And for that purpose, I'm gonna use my homemade taser. Okay, let's try it out.
Resistors resist against the current flow and convert the energy into heat.
Ow!
A capacitor stores energy in form of electric fields between electric charges and can later release them when a load is connected between.
Damn it!
If you don't know how to use them, they'll convert the energy into heat. Inductors store energy in the form of magnetic fields. Oh sh**. And yeah, I guess every wire has a resistance too.
Have you ever been so sad that you felt like a lump was appearing in your throat? We can't make
any promises now, can we be? High voltage makes me nervous as f. So let's try it.
I'm doing a fully soapy hand to give it the best shot, otherwise there'll be a hell of a pain.
Sorry guys, the pain is too much for me, but I'm sure it opens! Okay, let me check my body resistance and impedance. Tongue this. Okay, tongue at 3 volts. Is it chill that you're in my head? Cause I know that it's deadly. Maybe she dropped the wallet after in the water, completely submerged it, and then plugged it in. So I guess this is pretty dead. Now if I shove the magnet into the coil, I see that the voltage is generated. And the faster I go, the higher the amplitude, like this. Take it off. Ow! Plug it in to charge the phone. And short the live, which is the black wire, to the earth, which is the green, the breaker should pop. Now to start soldering your board, you need a solder gun. It's on.
Alright.
Just simply try to adjust the frequency of the circuit.
The phone and its charging cable are around the same non-lethal level, so dropping it in the bathtub is not harmful.
Launch in 3, 2, 1, 0. Houston, we have a problem.
Wow, the result was negligible. Yo.
I could plug it in so I can show you.
This is awesome.
Please join me for the first time to hear how it sounds. And 1, 2, 3, 4.
But they have a high voltage with respect to the center mesh. I can short it with my screwdriver for you to see the spark.
I use my clamp.
And I will turn it on with my power supply. Here I turn on the supply. See? No sparks. There is not even a high voltage here that I can feel. So it's impossible for this to excite the fluorescent bulb. What the f***?
When I had my finger stuck in the lighter and pulled the trigger, it zapped me. Let's charge the car battery. Now I have to wait a minute. Power supply here connected to these wires. This power supply can generate 20 volts 100%. Now it's time to lower the jack. Here's the power supply at 4 volts and I'm going to connect this thin wire to it. And you can see how the wire melts and burns under. Okay, you can see it still sparks. Let's try it out. What the? I thought I set it to 1 volt. Is it chill that you're in my... Okay, let me show you how well it works. First, without the anti-pair. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this yet? Let's try the taser now. Measure some waveforms. I connected the probe to my output lines, connected my circuit to this power bar, and now I will turn the power bar on. Sending energy to turn on the light. What if I bring my hand between the coil and the light? My hand blocks and absorbs some of the energy and the light goes dim. Am I getting cancer from this? Let me zap this one. There is no easy way to use this damn taser. Let's try it again. Let's give it a try. There we go, the charger LED is on. Now it's off. Turning much harder now.
Oh no.
I killed the phone.
What was that?
Well, I haven't touched that in a while. Maybe it doesn't hurt anymore.
170 volts. Now I like to use my 100 ohm resistor and connect it to the output to see how the waveform changes. Okay, finally, let's power it up.
Let's turn it on.
that a strong drill battery can take care of. My reputation.
Never do stupid shit that you will regret for the rest of your life. Promises now can we be, but you can make me
dream. Here is the piezo sparker I took out from the lighter. When you press the button, it sparks.
Out of all these, you get your own tiny taser that you can zap your friends with.
Is it chill that you're in my head? Cause I know that it's delicate. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this yet? Cause I know that it's delicate. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this yet? Yeah.